Hello learners, I am Dr. Sunita Sundriyal and today we shall study the topic Leadership Functions. This topic comes under the paper 507 Community and Elementary Education under D.El.Ed program run by NIOS on distance mode for the distance learners. Before we move on to the content, let us understand what are the aims and objectives of studying our topic today, that is the Leadership Functions. The aims are to understand the functions operating under a leader and his leadership, to know about the difference in functions based on different leadership model, to determine the functions a successful leader must possess to portray a strong leadership, and lastly, to differentiate between the various leadership functions according to the leadership model which we are going to study. Now, before moving to the functions, we must know what is leadership. Leadership functions are decided by people who are influenced directly or indirectly by the leaders. In a school, if we see, they are the students, colleagues, other employees, parents, and societies. We know various leaders show different styles of working. They have different mannerisms and behaviors to show their leadership style. So there are various functions according to different leadership style. It is difficult to elucidate all the functions of different types of leaders. Therefore, based on leadership model given by various members like Leithwood, Hellinger, Murphy, etc., various leadership functions are decided according to the leadership model. Now, let us see what those different leadership models are. These different leadership models are instructional leadership model, transformational leadership model, distributive leadership model and transactional leadership model, moral leadership model and contingent leadership model. In instructional leadership model, which deals with instructions, academics, work, culture of employees, transformational focuses on transforming the subordinates from good to better. Distributive shows how the members share the responsibilities and duties and participate in functioning of organization. Transactional deals with what is to be decided necessarily and how the short-term goals are to be achieved. Moral deals with the leadership style in which good conduct is to be shown. And contingent leadership model deals with adjustment and cooperative type of functioning so that a situation can be tackled. On this leadership style, we can understand how the leaders function. To begin with, the first leadership model, let us see the image. What does the image project before you? How are the blue figures organized? Can you guess the type of functioning it is reflecting? You must have seen an orchestra playing. There you must have seen one man guiding with a stick or baton. He uses it to instruct the musician to play their musical instrument. But these musicians also have a sheet of paper with notes of music to follow while playing music. Similarly, in an institution, the leader or the principal gives instructions to his leaders, to his subordinates, to his members, and to the teachers so that they can work according to his instruction. This has to be done in any institution to get a good success rate, to get a high achievement level. This type of functioning is based on instructional leadership model. Let us discuss the functions in detail. Which are that the principal is the sole leader is the function of this type of model. The principal takes the whole project in his leadership style and gives instructions accordingly. The functions revolve around instructions and achievement, mainly academic achievements. The functions revolve around the teaching learning process. It also involves educators, staff and students. We can say that it is more of a participatory management process where all participating in one or the other way during the academic and administrative process. The other functions involved in this leadership model are it determines clear goals and implements policies. The collaboration with teachers and other subordinates is required where the democratic setup is included. Motivates subordinates to work for better performance and achievements. The subordinates are given good motivations, reinforcement, so that they can perform better and better to increase the achievement level of their institution. In this, a healthy environment is maintained in school. It promotes professional development of all. Since all the members, the teachers and colleagues are involved in this process, the development of each one is ensured. And in this working, there develops a suitable and supportive environment to work for. Now look at the next image. What do you see in this image? What is the red figure trying to do? How are the blue figures organized? Can you guess the type of functioning? The functioning here is, you can see, the leader is helping other one to climb the stairs. A blue image is catching hold of the another one. Both the pictures are obvious in expressing the helpful nature of the leader. He does not seem to or want to leave behind his subordinate. Even the desk person is helped by his leader in blue while doing work in computer. So we can say that a change, a person from good to better, is done in this leadership model. Here the leader tries to transform his team member. This type of leadership model, where the function is to support, to cooperate, is known as the transformational leadership model. We can say that main function is to transform subordinates into better performers. To do so, the goals must be set while all work together to make the organization excel. In this functioning, the leader acts as a facilitator and guide. He shows the path and helps the employees and community members to tread on it successfully and reach the goal. Leader not only leads but works equally with the subordinates for needed transformation and revamping. Here, not only the proper leader but also the subordinates and teachers become leader. Working together brings a feeling of togetherness and they work in unison and unity. In this way, the work can be done in a better manner, and with cooperation and coordination, it can lead to success. It motivates and boosts the morale of the performers, and the performances does not decline. The leader must function as role model for subordinates if he wants to transform the people influenced directly or indirectly by him. The leader must be an inspiration for them as to how to work for an organization with dedication. For this, the employees need to maintain their interest in work. The leader himself must not lose his or her interest during the working. This will inspire other subordinates and members to do better and better. He understands weaknesses and strengths of the employee. In this way, he can play around with the strengths of the employees, strengthen and polish his skills, and while understanding his weaknesses, he helps his subordinates to overcome these weaknesses so that he can come out as a strong person. It helps subordinates to overcome weaknesses and polish their skills. Leithwood points out that this leadership includes inspire, motivate, look beyond self-interest, and enable all to share vision. Inspire others so that they follow the leader. Motivate people so that they do not feel low or disheartened. Help people look beyond their self-care and self-interest, and to enable them share the vision and mission of the organization. With this mission and vision, the leader as well as the subordinates can move forward with their work to raise the heights of success for their institution and the organization. Now moving on to the another topic, let us see the image. What do you see in the image? Very interesting one. What do you think is happening? An arrow is pointing towards the leader. Why is this so? What can you decipher from this whole scenario? The leader seems to be pointing towards the goal or destination. They are pulling the workload and all are equally involved, including the leader. We can say that the work is being shared by all of them. What can you say about the leadership style or functioning of the leadership style? Obviously, this is the shared and distributive leadership model where the functions are shared between the teachers, the subordinates, the colleagues with the leader. As the name suggests, the functions are distributed. The leadership responsibility is given to the team members. It believes in division of work. All the members are given equal responsibilities. For example, when organizing a function in a school, The principal gives out certain duties. For example, the cultural head is given all the responsibility related to cultural programs. The finance leadership is given to a person who can handle finances very well. Similarly, other duties are assigned to different people and they do their work accordingly. All the responsibilities does not lie on the leader only. Dynamic, interactive individuals are engaged in the group. Obviously, the person who is talented, who knows his work well, is engaged. The experience, knowledge, and skills of the team members are utilized. In this manner, each one feels job satisfaction. They tend to work to reach the goals, and they are well aware that togetherness will lead to the aim and being apart will tag them as losers. All in all, they work together to achieve set goals and reach their objectives. Shared responsibilities among the members helps to lessen the load, as a result of which they can function effectively. Also, the shared responsibilities keeps the load distributed properly among the workers, and there is effective functioning with much more ease and perfection. The functions based on this model is aimed at enhancing performance by the participation of all and sundry. This type of functioning brings about more coordination among the members. The members coordinate and gel to work with more spirit and enthusiasm. Now look at this image. There are two images in this slide. The top one, where the leader is sitting and the people around him are doing certain work. And in the second figure, you can see the leader has taken the center place with the subordinates and all are doing certain kind of work. In the above picture, what do you think is happening? Can you guess the type of leadership? In first case, the text displays that he is the boss. When boss shows bossism, he is not bothered or concerned with others' thoughts or ideas or working. But in the second picture, both leaders and members are ready to show some ninja moves, and if not sufficient, the leader becomes a shooter to face a crisis and works along with his subordinates so that they can overcome the crisis or emergency situation. So in the transactional leadership model, the functions are as follows. The function foremost is to be target oriented. What does target oriented mean? That is, the target is the goal or any crisis which is to be tackled. To achieve the target fixed, the functions revolve around three main dimensions. They are supervision, organization, and performance. Supervision means what is the target and how it will be met. Next is organization, where the resources and how are they to be organized and assimilated is seen. And third is performance, which is the main one. It is the time where all organized elements are to be used practically. So performance helps in achieving our goal. In this leadership style, the main function is also being directive and action oriented. Also in this functioning, there is use of rewards and punishment to gain compliance and agreement of the subordinates. And the last one is to use to accomplish short-term goals. The function is to use it effectively in some crisis or emergency, or work according to existing systems of the organization. In this functioning, no new change is introduced. Only the crisis or emergency situations are tackled with. Now look at this figure. What do you see in this figure? There are four people in this figure. What are they trying to do? The image expresses that wherever we work, the values play an important role in that system. Here the image shows the value of support, the value of cooperation, the value of lending a helping hand, the value of being selfless without being selfish, and to work together in a group so that our work can be finished off. This type of leadership comes under moral leadership, where irrespective of any background of teachers, students, or others, functioning occurs, and these factors, that is the background, does not hamper with the working. To understand this properly, let us move on to this topic in detail. In this leadership model, the function cannot work individually. It has to be integrated with other leadership model. It is used best when integrated with different styles of leadership. It gives a good result when incorporated with other styles and tends to motivate sense of ethics and values. All the members of team understand that they have to take responsibility and present themselves as an ideal person. This adds personal and humanistic touch to the whole affair. The leader as well as the teachers become model for the people they influence, that is the colleague, students and community. They tend to help personally by giving guidance and consultation. The leader introspects, that means he self-observes, he self-evaluates himself, he thinks critically and conducts impeccably. In this functioning, the leadership and respect go hand in hand. It is not wrong to say that leadership and respect motivates them to work harder and endure. Thus, the functioning system has embedded values without which the work may lose its humanitarian value. Now, let us move on to the next image. View the image carefully. What do you see? There are two images. In the above picture, you see the man is standing and explaining something to the other members. The picture below shows a very interesting scene. What is the woman facing the group doing? What is the atmosphere in that place? How are group members reacting? Both images reflect almost similar situation. In the above picture, a mature leader is explaining to the young members, but in an informal manner. The below picture shows a woman is demonstrating something and the group is listening to her very attentively. They are very cheerful and they do not have any gender biasness that a woman is explaining to something. They are all involved together. They are all above the gender and they are working in a group. The woman is explaining them certain activity and they are listening to it. This type of functioning where the work goes on with maintaining of interrelationship is based on contingent leadership model. Let us understand it more. According to this model, the functions are to show dependent and reliant type of performance. The leader is always ready to support subordinates so that they do not feel left out. It helps them to feel as involved in the work. The leader builds a good rapport and relation amongst the people. The people come together with positive feeling to work together as in a contingent. So it shows dependent and reliant type of functioning where there is equal support to the subordinates and a good rapport is built up among the employees. Whatever the condition, they change their role and functions according to the demand of situation. We can say in this type of leadership model, the function is basically based on interrelationship among the employees or the members. The relationship among the people should be healthier and the relationship should be task-oriented. It means that relationship should not be such that the task is overlooked or the task should not be of such a main focus that the relationship is overlooked. So both have to go hand in hand. Main focus, as I said, is on interrelationship. The change may occur many like government policy, administrative policy, etc. The function is to balance the working according to the changing needs and the necessities. The balancing act helps to run the ordeal smoothly and fluently. But to balance is equally tough and difficult. Thus, the work is organized according to the nature of environment undergoing change. So, it organizes the work according to the nature of the environment or the atmosphere at that particular time. If there is any change, it has to be manipulated and this manipulation can be of the subordinate or the conditions or the process. For this, the leader functions as a manipulator and he manipulates the work in unison and complements each other's style of work. There is a need to avoid the conflict and for this, the above function should be performed. All this together in concoction ensures task completion to aid good achievement. So this is how leader functions. Today we discussed different leadership styles and this leadership style which we are discussed is contingency leadership style. Today we discussed various leadership model and under which how a good leader functions. So, according to it, we have studied the leader's functions and the models which today we covered was the transformational leadership model, moral leadership model, transactional leadership model, distributor leadership model, and instructional leadership model. All have different functions, and the leader performs differently in all these leadership styles. Based on these leadership styles, if these functions are performed in a positive manner and taken together, a leader can function as a very leadership style. He can perform and become a good leader. So, overall, recapitulating this whole, let us understand in a summary these leadership style, that how a good leader functions. Keeping in mind the following pointers in mind, like working with clear goals in mind. Dear learners, follow the chart properly, and I am starting with the clear goals. So a clear goal should be there for a good leader to function properly. When there is a set goal, a clear goal in the mind of a good leader, he can be a good instructional leader. And moving on further, he should come up with good and ideal examples where required. He must present good examples so that it becomes an ideal situation for the employees. He must keep a vision while functioning. His vision and mission should be clear. He must keep his communication clear. He can communicate his ideas. He should take ideas and suggestions from the employees. Both should interchange and exchange their ideas. Keep the expectation high to look out for the best. When the expectation is high, the leader will always aim for the best. Always be supportive during process. He must give total cooperation and coordinate with his members. And while doing so in this process, he must give proper encouragement, motivation and reinforcement to his employees so that they work with equal zeal and enthusiasm. He must give due recognition to his members to keep their morale up. He should give stimulating work to provide opportunities to show creativity and innovation. He should keep interest and needs in priority list. The needs and interest will always move forward the employees to work better and better and aim higher. The leader should be an inspiration for the people around. If the leader is an ideal person, he takes interest, he is totally enthusiastic in his work, totally motivated, then only he can keep his environment lively and full of zeal. He should be an inspiration. Always work for the integrity of the organization. The organization should be his topmost priority. He should work for his organization. He should think for his organization. And he should think of the people working in his organization. So, dear learners, today we took different instructional models and the functions according to it. And I hope you must be able to differentiate between the functioning according to these different instructional models. And all the models are equally important, as all the functions carried out are equally important for an organization to become a successful and reach its pinnacle. So, finishing it off, thanking you for listening the lecture carefully. Thanks.